In this video, I want to talk to you about forward integration, backward integration, and balanced integration. I also want to talk to you about complete integration. There is a difference between all of this, and before you start any business, you need to know the difference between all of this, what is best suited for your business, and how you will conduct your business. These are systems that are scalable, and it happens in every business. There is not even one business on the planet that doesn't do these. Okay, so without further ado, let me just go into it. I'll try to help you the best way I can to my abilities, and you will be able to understand what is best for your business by the end of this video. That is the aim of this video. So as you know, I do a lot of consulting for business professionals, for businesses in total, and my team does that. So this was something that I'm doing right now for a very big company, and they are launching something new and they wanted to know. So of course you need someone who is that skilled to understand what is best for you. You might need a personal person. So if that is the case, you can contact me or anyone. You don't have to contact me, but anyone, and they will help you with what is specifically tailored for your business. But this should give you a general idea of what is best for your business. So let's go forward. First thing you have to know is there are 5 business processes that every business has. Okay, so 5 business processes. The first one is procuring raw materials. You need to have raw materials that you are going to use to do something, to create a business, right? So if it is creating a product, you need the raw materials for that. So procuring the raw materials is stage 1. Stage 2 is intermediate goods. Now what this means is you are combining those goods, either yourself or you are combining those goods and you are using it. Many people have a misconception that service industry doesn't do these things. You have to collect people and then you have to train them. These are the 2 things that service industry does. So service industry is not exempt from this. Next thing any business has to do is manufacturing. They have to manufacture the goods. So whatever you are doing from stage 1 and stage 2, you are going to use that. You are going to manufacture it and create a product. Product will be created. After that, what you have to do is, many people forget about these 2 things, that is marketing and sales. You need to market your product, you need to do the sales of your product, and then only will people buy your product. One thing that is forgotten as a business process is after sales and support. That's the 5th business process. After sales and support is also a business process. Okay, so let's go forward. Now, first thing, let's go literally forward. What is forward integration? The different processes that you are going to use yourself, the different processes that you are going to conduct yourself, that is the difference between these forward integration, backward integration, upward, and all these kind of integrations. So what is forward integration? Forward integration, you control the marketing, you control the sales and marketing, you control the manufacturing, and you also control the after sales. This is what many of the companies use. You are not procuring the raw materials, you are not doing the initial component building, you are just doing the manufacturing. That is, the you have some sub dealer, sub people who are going to do the initial product development or create small parts of your product. You are just assembling it together and you are getting it done. Okay, that is forward integration. You only control manufacturing, after sales, and the sales and marketing. These are the only 3 things you control. The next thing that you have to understand is backward integration. Some companies prefer to do this because it gives you the most control over the quality of your product. So what you do in this is, in backward integration, you are procuring the raw materials, you are doing the initial assembling, and you are doing the manufacturing. You don't do the sales and marketing. You franchise your sales and marketing to different players and they do the sales and marketing. And you also try to franchise your after sales, because the sales is not in your hand. So automatically the after sales is also in the franchisee's hands. As you can see, these are not complete systems. All of these have certain shortcomings. In the forward integration, you don't have control over the quality of your product as much as backward integration. And in backward integration, you don't have as much control over the product after sales and the product sales or marketing. This is where balanced integration comes into play. In balanced integration, you don't do the raw materials gathering, that is not done by you, but you do the initial goods assembling and the manufacturing. So two things you are doing there, and then you are doing the sales and marketing also. Only thing you are franchising here is the after sales. So the raw material procuring and the after sales, you are giving that to franchises, and other companies, sub companies are doing that. These are the different types. Now, there is one type of integration that you don't see generally, that is total integration. Very few companies do total integration. You can have only probably hand few companies, you know, you can count them, they are that few, because it's really expensive. That is total integration. In total integration, you are controlling the raw material procurement, you are controlling the initial development and creation of the product, that is sub-assembly is controlled, you are controlling the total manufacturing of the product, you are controlling sales and marketing, and you are also controlling the after sales. You might be thinking, think about it, you know, you might be thinking that Apple does this. No, Apple gives over their manufacturing to China, so Apple is not controlling the manufacturing there. There are very few companies which does that and who do this. You can try to find out, you can try to, this is your homework, you can say, but it'll try to teach you a lot. There are very few companies who do this completely. Which is best for you? Coming to the point, it depends. There is no, you know, full and one size fits all. It depends on the product, it depends on the industry, it depends on a lot of variables. You need a person who has that kind of expertise, who can guide you and who has experience that can, you know, about the market, about how markets work in general. A person who has, you know, you don't necessarily need a person who has a lot of degrees, because degrees are not going to help you. This is where experience comes in. So you need a person who has been an entrepreneur. That is why I would suggest getting these kind of details or these kind of things created, these kind of things sorted out with people who have the experience firsthand. That is why many people actually go forward to people who have already created companies as mentors, and they solve this. So do some business consulting on this. If you're trying to launch a big company, there might be a special thing that you need to do. If you do it wrong, what is going to happen is you will either lose control, or you might not be able to do it as good as you should be doing. I know this is a long video, but it has to be long. There is a lot of information that I had to go through and I had to give to you in a simple form. If you have any comments, suggestions, all these things, you know what to do. Like, share, comment, everything. This has been Jamie for TopEvt. I'll see you in the next video.